bit about the book, man. What made you want to go ahead and I don't know if you're an author, I don't know if you've released several books, but what made you want to take a step into this journey?
No, this is my first like real book. I've definitely been writing a long time. Like I've done a blog, I've done like a kind of a mini book that I just kind of like tossed up on Amazon. But this is like the first real book, kind of start to finish. And honestly, like the thing that I think kind of made it happen was just that I was like publicly committed to doing it and felt like I had a unique kind of opportunity from the very beginning. You know, this is a little bit of like, I don't even know if I jumped off a cliff so much as like fell and was like, I guess we're learning to fly. Here we go.
I love that. How long have you been either ingesting some of Naval's thoughts or following him in that content?
I mean, I've been following Naval for 10 years, probably. I mean, when I was in Michigan, I had like, didn't know much about the Valley, just kind of knew I wanted to get into the startup world and like had the entrepreneurship bug. And the first like legit Valley real people that I met were like, dude, go read all of Paul Graham and go read all of Venture Hacks and follow Naval. Cause he was just getting started with some of the blogging and building AngelList at the time. I was like, okay. So he was kind of introduced to me as this like icon of the Valley. And so when he's like a cultural setter, and that was where I started, but it's been probably more than 10 years since then. So I've just been like following on Twitter and listening to talks and trying to learn what I could from him. And so, it, you know, over those years, I've learned a lot and I've been recommending him and following him. So I felt like I was in a pretty good, you know, I just had accumulated this sort of base of knowledge and respect for all of the things. You know, I have a lot of overlapping interests. You know, he talks about sci-fi and futurism and education and crypto and, you know, and wealth and happiness on a very principled level, and has like built and invested in successful companies. And those are all just things I'm interested in learning more about. So it came together pretty naturally.
I think most people probably know Naval. And this is kind of good and bad. This is really interesting because I think in Silicon Valley, we have our heroes and they're kind of ours, right? Like the world doesn't know about them. Like they could be sitting courtside at an NBA game and nobody will know who they are. And that's actually why I love some of these individuals, because they're icons, but no one knows who they are. And it's really nice, or the majority of people. Naval was on the Joe Rogan podcast. And I think that might have been a place where he got a lot of following but then again, it's hard to find him, right? He has a podcast, but he's not out there. He's not like verified even on Instagram. He's not in a place where people are, did that make it hard to write the book? Did that like, how did you go about dissecting all of his information everywhere?
Yeah. I mean, that's kind of what made me want to write the book, just because it's interesting. Like you and I, at least, are really deep in like the podcast world and the Twitter world. And those like feel like huge places, but they're really not like that mainstream in the scheme of things. Like most people don't listen to podcasts, I think. And like, not everybody's on Twitter, certainly, at least not to the degree that they would automatically know who Naval is down that like tech Twitter rabbit hole. And I think, you know, some of these ideas, I just over and over again would recommend them to friends or family members or whatever. I'm like, well, here's what Naval had said about that, or here's what I learned about this. And people don't, if they're not podcast people, or they're not Twitter people, there's no access to those ideas. And they're kind of like, yeah, sure, whatever. And I'm like, all right, I'm going to take this stuff that's like shared in this kind of niche format almost, and like this ephemeral format, right? Because like tweets just disappear after, you know, not very long, and podcast discoverability is, let's call it, unsolved. But everybody knows what to do with a book, and books can like stay around forever, and they're giftable and they're handoffable, and they're, you know, they sit on a shelf until you need them, or they kind of meet you where they are. And so it's just, you know, it's such a timeless format, and it's a more universal format. And I just really wanted to, you know, take these ideas that were so valuable to me and bring them into a little bit more of of something timeless.
Hey everyone, thanks for checking out that clip. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit the like button down below. And if you're interested in hearing the full episode, it's out right now on our YouTube channel. We've had a lot of great guests come on this show before, and we've got a lot of great guests coming up in the future. So hit subscribe so that you don't miss a single episode. And one final note, we're always looking for new ideas and new companies to feature on the show. So if you know of someone or know of a company, write us a comment down below letting us know who they are and what they do. We'd be happy to have them on the show. Till then, I'll just be here waiting for your comments. So see you later.